Before we start the meeting, is there anyone who would like to address the council in any public comments relating to any of the agenda items tonight? Thank you. I'd like to thank everyone for coming out tonight, nice crowd. The days are getting shorter, I see twilight is with us already. Clock says it's 7 o'clock, if you can stand please. Lord, we thank you for being here with us tonight. We thank you for taking care of us and all the blessings that you bestow on us. Lord, we ask you tonight that you keep your hand upon our council as we determine the future of our city and we make decisions that affect everything from our finances to our water supply. Lord, we ask you to direct those decisions and what would be best for all of our citizens and everyone concerned. We ask you to keep your hand upon all of our employees, Lord. Keep them safe and take care of them. And we're careful to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Amen.
We'll call this meeting to order. Ms. Kelly, if you would call the roll.
Lee.
Here.
Carpenter.
Here.
Klein.
Present.
Smalling.
Here.
Savitsky.
Here.
Let the record reflect that everyone is present and we have a quorum, so we will continue with the meeting. The first item that we'll do is adopt the agenda.
So make a motion to adopt.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to adopt the agenda as is. Any further discussion? Hearing none. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, like sign. Motion carries unanimously. We had no one for public comments, so the next item will be the minutes from the August 18, 2016 meeting.
Make a motion to approve the August 18th meeting.
Second.
Have a motion and a second to approve the August 18th meeting minutes. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Any opposed, like sign. Motion carries unanimously. Next item is the minutes from the September 1st, 2016 special called meeting.
Make a motion to pass the minutes for the special called meeting.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to accept the minutes as read. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, like sign. Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Next item on the agenda is the financial statement.
Make a motion to approve the financial statement.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve a financial statement. Any further discussion? Hearing none, I'll call for the vote.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Klein?
Yes.
Smalling?
Yes.
Savitsky?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Under new business, the first item is a fall cleanup date. We set October the 15th. The 15th for that. Adam, you weren't here. Is that going to be okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
And that will be 8 to 12?
Yeah.
You want to get three dumpsters on that?
We only had two during the
spring. I don't know if it'll be worse or, I mean, when we had those two full, I don't know if there'll be more or not. We always got the garbage trucks if we was to fill up too much. We can fill the garbage trucks up with normal stuff, not any metal.
Okay. I hear a motion to set that date in stone.
Make a motion to have October 15th as fall cleanup date, from 8 to noon.
Second.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, I'll call for the vote.
Klein.
Yes.
Smalling.
Yes.
Savitsky.
Yes.
Lee.
Yes.
Carpenter.
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. The next item is to advertise for dredging for Westmoreland Lake. Caleb?
I've talked to Codes Enforcement Officer Timothy Farley, and in the past, we've had somebody actually willing to dredge the lake for the silt. And I want to see, after talking to Mr. Farley again, if we could actually advertise through free channels to see if somebody would be willing to dredge the lake for the silt again at no cost to the taxpayers or the city, if we can find somebody.
I done an example notice to the Tennessean. It was going to run around $643.49, but there are several free advertisement sites available in the state of Tennessee to advertise on. I can also advertise on MTAS. But instead of putting this, and this was an idea I wanted to run by y'all, I can go ahead and contact TWRA and the Corps of Engineers and see if they've got a list of people that does it and solicit quotes instead of getting bids, and that'll give us a better idea, you know, and let them know what we're looking for. That way, it, you know, we're not breaking any policies.
We're not going to cost us anything to
no,
do this.
No,
yeah.
Let's, you know,
bids and quotes.
Free. Well, I mean, it would be like asking for a quote, you know, just getting a list of people that does this that we can communicate with.
Yeah.
As long as I'm communicating with them one-on-one, it's not breaking any legal notices or anything like that. Because actually, we're not advertising to pay somebody to do it. We're soliciting, trying to get it done for nothing.
I think that's an excellent idea.
So I think, you know, you just get a list of people, then we can contact them individually and kind of get fill them out and see what, if they want to offer us something, then we can bring it back before the council for acceptance.
There may even be something through TWRA.
Yeah, well, TWRA did the last time.
Which was, what, approximately 15 years ago? You said it's supposed to be done every 5-10 years tops.
10 years tops. But like I said, the main thing is to keep that main channel clean under that bridge where water can get fresh water and get down there and circulate through. A friend of mine at TWRA, he's been actually promoted to director of this Middle Tennessee area. So although I didn't ask for anything yet, he does have some names and stuff, but I want to get permission from the council to pursue talking to them individually.
Would it be best to make a motion to advertise to solicit for dredging the lake, or?
Yeah, I think for free.
For free.
We even have to make a motion right now.
Yeah, I think you ought to just
I think
go
it should
through
be
those
just
channels
left as,
and us table it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also, the way I look at it, it's kind of a codes issue with the lake being stopped up like now, so technically I can actually ask questions and talk to people about how to get it cleaned up, if that makes sense to y'all, is what I'm saying.
Okay. Want to make motion table motion?
Then I can have y'all something maybe for the study and be put on the next meeting. Because from what I'm looking at it now as a problem with the lake not filtering correctly, so I can pursue whatever channels I need to try to get that problem corrected.
Okay.
Motion to table advertising.
Yes.
There a second?
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to table advertising for dredging the Westmoreland Lake. Any further discussion? Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, like sign. It is tabled with a unanimous vote. Next item is Resolution 09-2016-1, updated for 2006 fire codes to 2012 fire codes.
Make a motion we approve Resolution 09-2016-01.
I'll second. Now discussion from Mr. Jenkins, Chief Jenkins.
Any questions?
It's all pretty well stated out here.
Right, we have stayed within 7 years of the state, and the state adopted 2012 on August the 3rd of this year. So now we have to get on board and do that also.
And note one thing, this can be done by resolution because it was initially done by ordinance, but it can be changed by resolution, is how we've done in the past, and it will go effective once it's passed. If it's passed, then it will go into effect, which will both have to order a set of new books.
Mm-hmm. One copy is supposed to be at the city hall.
Yeah.
So we'll need three copies of the book?
Minimum two for each of us.
Then you got the building codes. Was it 7?
Any further discussion? Call for the vote.
Smalling?
Yes.
Savitsky?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Klein?
Yes.
Let the record reflect that it's a unanimous vote. The motion carries. Next item is Resolution 09-2016-2, update for 2009 building codes to 2012.
Make a motion to adopt building and residential codes from 2009-2012.
I second that motion.
Okay. Open for discussion.
That also needs to be with omitting the
explosion
provisions.
Yes, sir. I'll amend the motion to include that.
Amend it to?
To allow the omission.
On the property maintenance. Exceptions.
We're not adopting the property maintenance part of the 2009 IBC and IRC. It's better to keep that under your local jurisdiction because what they have is not in line with Tennessee state law. That's international, so your property maintenance needs to stay within your city ordinance and your current state with TCA. That's the reason for omitting the property maintenance part of it.
You okay with that, Brian?
Yeah, it's in the resolution.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah. I just want to make sure it's on. Yeah. I want to explain why, you know, that I'm omitted the property maintenance code.
It just made common sense.
Yeah.
Any further discussion? Okay. Call for the vote.
Vitsky?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Klein?
Yes.
Smalling?
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chief.
Next item on the agenda is to hire Justin Parker as a full-time police officer.
Thank you. In the wakes of Officer Mark Bartley resigning and also the council allowing us to have an eighth officer, Justin Parker, has applied. He has been working with us on a part-time basis, been helping us out great deal. And he desires a interest in coming back full-time. He's a Tennessee State Certified Law Enforcement Officer, had been for some time. He had worked for the department in the past. He is also a certified EMT, IV. He's certified in that. And Justin's has been a wonderful help to the department. They're working quite a bit. And I would like to ask the council to please hire him as a full-time officer for the Westmoreland Police Department.
Okay.
Make a motion to hire Officer Parker, recommendations of our chief.
I'll second.
Pay rate and probation period?
He'll be on a 3-month probationary period, and then after his 3 months is up, he would go, he's making $12.50 now. To the best of my knowledge, if I'm wrong, then he would go up to $13.25. That's the pay scale that is now, that they got now.
What was the pay on that rate?
It's $12.50.
Up to $13.25.
To $13.25, actually.
You also have been traveling from Knoxville?
Up until recently, yeah, I'm staying with in-laws now in Bowling Green, so now I'm coming from Bowling Green, but we went house hunting today. Might end up in Hendersonville because she's working at Vanderbilt, so we're trying to figure out a happy medium between the two.
Sounds great dedication, I appreciate that.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, who seconded?
I did.
And you are certified, right?
Yes, sir.
Worked for anybody else other than Westmoreland?
I started at Union County Sheriff's Department, came to Westmoreland, worked for Greenbrier. I moved back to East Tennessee, and now we're moving back.
How long did you work for Westmoreland Police Department before?
Almost a year. Mm-hmm. Maybe I started in May of 2014 until December 2014.
Mm-hmm. Any other discussion? I'll call for the vote, Ms. Kelly.
Lee?
Yes.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Klein?
Yes.
Smalling?
Yes.
Zabitski?
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Welcome home.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Next item is to hire Michael Sutherland as a full-time police officer.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, in the wakes of Mark Bartley resigning, and also the council giving us the 8th officer. We have found Michael Sutherland. He is a Tennessee State Certified Officer through the Tennessee Law Enforcement Training Academy. Very good scores in the academy. He also served 4 years in the United States Navy as an operations specialist. He also served as an armed security officer for the state of Tennessee. Also through, I think it's Hendersonville Hospital he worked. And he has also been working with us part-time and has been a great deal of help, wonderful help. With him and with Parker, I've tentatively done a October schedule, and it looks wonderful. It looks a lot better than what it has been. So it would just drop the number of hours officers are working. And I would like to ask the council to please consider hiring Michael Sutherland as a full-time officer.
I make a motion to hire Officer Sutherland, the recommendations of Ray, the same pay scale.
Second.
You're also IT tech, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
No?
Okay. Handled radar and radio communications in the Navy, but no IT experience. No.
Oh, don't be modest.
I wish I did. It would be a valuable tool to have, but I don't, unfortunately.
Okay, we have the motion and the second. Any other discussion? I'll call for the vote.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Klein?
Yes.
Smalling?
Yes.
Zabitski?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Welcome to the department.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate that. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ray.
Next item on the agenda is to replace the traffic lights with LED lights for the S&W contracting contract that we discussed. Do I hear a motion?
I make a motion to replace traffic lights with LED lights per S&W contracting. That was for a cost of $2,100. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Now we'll discuss it.
We have had numerous problems with the traffic light. I think Tim had told me that we're pretty deep into it right now.
We're almost at that amount right now for this year on
repairs.
On repairs for the
because they have to come out and ask for when it's a minimum of $400 each time they come out.
And the equipment and the lights is so old that they're having to order it, and it's just, it's a higher cost than what it is right now. With this right here, with the LED, they're giving us a 5-year warranty and a lot less maintenance problems on it. And if we do have a problem, it's going to be a lot cheaper.
All this is just keeping the shell and replacing all the
heads. Yes, sir.
This is a, when they told me the price, I about fell over. This is a wonderful upgrade to the red light.
I was going to say, it seems like most of the checks that I signed for them are in the $600 range for repairs.
Like I said, it's a minimum of $400, but for every hour to here, well, I think I told Ray, what, six something?
Yes.
$575, $600.
They came out on Christmas one time, and I think that was even a little higher.
I think we're around $1,800 right now from the times we've had to call on, from what I quickly noted.
Can something like that come out of the street aid budget with it being a traffic light?
I don't see no reason why it could.
That's what state street aid funds are for. It's perfect for that.
We have funds for it.
In state street.
Okay. Okay, any other discussion? I'll call for the vote.
Klein.
Yes.
Smalling.
Yes.
Savitsky.
Yes.
Lee.
Yes.
Carpenter.
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Chief.
Thank you, Tim.
Next item is contract with Next Bill Pay for credit card services. Ms. Kelly.
I provided you with a copy of the contract with our current Harley Financial. It was for a 3-year contract as of October 2014. There is a $250 charge for us to stop working with them earlier than that. Of course, there are monthly fees, and I think it would just about come out even, you know, for us to stop working with them now. Next Bill Pay is not going to charge us any fees at all. What they actually charge per transaction is about the same per transaction. What the customer will pay will be a slight bit more, but if we end up using them, the customer service is, I feel like, is going to be tremendously better. I see a lot more benefits with them. I've had a really hard time with our current credit card company. And the way that they do it, we basically keep our hands out of any of the transactions. If we go through interfacing through local government, we don't even enter the payments at all. It just basically keeps us out of the credit card process altogether, other than when people come in and actually make payments in the office. And there are ways around us doing that also. So, and I'd like to see us get out of completely even having credit card numbers for our safety, for customer safety, you know, just all the way around.
Because these two are so closely tied together, go ahead and speak to the next item. And we'll vote separate on them, but go ahead and speak to it because, like I said, it's what relates to it.
Okay. As far as interfacing with local government, what that would allow is for when a customer, if they don't even have to be going online to pay their bill, but it would allow them for when they go online to pay their bill to look at their payment history, to look at their usage history, how much their bill was, how much their usage was, without having to call and talk to us. Obviously, they can still call and talk to us, but if they've got it at their fingertips. I like the idea of, for myself, being able to pull it up and look at it, you know, from a home computer, from the phone, whatever. being able to make that payment other than just having to already have your bill and know how much your bill is to make that payment. You have access to that information. We're hoping to be able to do the same thing to pay, you know, there's two sides of it. It's paying your water bill and having that information, also being able to pay tickets, paying property taxes, anything that you would pay in the office right now, you can pay online. With interfacing with local government, it would also allow us to have a 1-800 number where people could call and pay their bills over the phone, not speaking to us to pay the bill over the phone, but they would actually pay it through the 1-800 number, which would allow 24/7 being able to make their payments. When I say it costs a little bit more, I mean probably less than a dollar, where we charge the $2 fee now, maybe $2.75 to make that payment. But there again, you have access to all your information about your account, and you can do it any time of day, weekends, whatever. So I feel like the benefits way outweigh anything negative. As far as what we're charged for local government, there's the one-time fees of setting up, I believe it's $440 for the general, and then the same for the water, and then there's the yearly charge to keep it going. She told me it would take possibly about a month to get it set up and going, so we could get it going about the time that property taxes are in the swing of things, and that would be amazing too. It means less work for us in the office, but it also means
people can view all their items online.
Yes. I believe she said that you could not pay the property taxes over the telephone.
Was what you said at the work study, mm-hmm. But you could still pay it with credit card.
Right, you could still pay that, online. But you couldn't pay it over the phone. There's a few things that, you know, I still have to figure out, but I've asked everything I could possibly think of to ask. And, you know, she has been wonderful. Any time I've had a question, she's been great about just calling me right back. If I email her, she calls me within an hour. I mean, she's just been great to work with.
Did you check on the written notice to the card company we're using now?
I did not. I haven't been in the office enough to even do that. Okay.
Yeah, it's something that we need to make as a provision to the motion if this passes, but because you know, if you got to give a 90-day notice on it or something like that, could throw a wrench in it.
Okay. And you know, it could be that it takes, you know, like I said, we're looking at least a month to get the new one set up for local government.
They furnishing all the equipment also. Well, we've discussed it at the work study, and you've heard further discussion here tonight. I've done it kind of backwards, but do we hear a motion on the contract with Next Bill Pay?
Make a motion to have a contract in place with Next Bill Pay for credit services with contingent upon canceling the old service.
I'll second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second for the contract with Next Bill Pay for credit card services, contingent to getting the first contract canceled. Any further discussion? Okay, I'll call for the vote.
Smalling.
Yes.
Sadisky.
Yes.
Lee.
Yes.
Carpenter.
Yes.
Klein.
Yeah.
Let the record show that the motion carries unanimously. And the companion to that one is a software agreement with local government to interface with the credit card company. Do I hear a motion?
I'll make a motion to enter into a software agreement with the local, government to interface with Next Bill Pay.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any other discussion?
Would you mind amending that to make it contingent upon canceling this?
Yes. I'll amend that to make it contingent on cancellation with Harley Financial Services.
Okay, so noted. Any other discussion? Okay, call for the vote.
Savisky.
Yes.
Lee.
Yes.
Carpenter.
Yes.
Klein.
Yes.
Smalling.
Yes. Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. The next item on the agenda is cleaning City Hall and the community room. Okay, we discussed this some at the work study, but we didn't have really all the information that we needed. So I guess I ought to do this one correctly. Is there a motion for this? So we can discuss it.
Make a motion to table it until the next work study.
Okay.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to table this until the work study, but give you time to get more information together on it.
Would you like me to, like, give you a plan or a proposed?
That would be fine. Okay. Any other discussion?
No discussion on motion to table.
Oh, okay. Thank you. We need to vote on it.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Start the vote.
Call for the vote.
Lee.
Yes.
Carpenter.
Yes.
Klein.
Yes.
No. Oh.
He's fine.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Klein.
Yes.
Carpenter. I was just, you can. Smalling.
No, I don't want to table it.
Yes.
Okay, with a vote of 4-1, this item will be tabled. And you will bring me a plan. Okay. Next item on the agenda is the city Facebook page. I believe Caleb has that.
Make a motion first to adopt an official city Facebook page with the understanding that it would be closed to comments and information output only. With Moran and Ms. Moran and Mr. Farley in charge of that page.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. To have an official city Facebook page with closed comments and be administered by Mr. Farley and Ms. Moran. Okay, we'll open it up for discussion.
And information output only.
Information output only. This way citizens can actually go to the page and see what roads are going to be closed, if we have any water problems, boiling alerts, water bills due, whatnot.
Is there a charge for the service?
There is no charge. Unless if we actually promote the page, which if you want me to amend that agenda, I will also amend it to not to charge or not to promote the page through spending taxpayer dollars.
Okay.
Police department currently has one of the best Facebook pages in
Middle Tennessee. So we can put a link between the two.
Yes.
And that'll automatically boost the city's Facebook page tremendously.
Not only that, but just north of Nashville, YouTube clips can be added on for these council meetings onto that. It would be for information output to the city so the city can know what's going on, especially in time of crisis.
Just the notice on the trash that I put out that week, it made a big difference this week with me and the trash ordeals going on. So I can see benefits from it. I can see it not being too big of a hassle for either one of us, but it would be good for notifications for cleanup day. If we have a water line break or something like that, we have to have a way to notify everybody. So if we can put that link in that ties it with the police department and automatically get that boost, that way we don't have to
do it twice. Wherever you put in, automatically goes to the
city. Share it with each other. Plus the cities will get a boost off the her page that's already established. So that automatically gives them a boost.
And there's no charge for that.
There's no charge for that. That's one way we can boost the page immediately.
Yeah. Okay. Any other discussion? Call for the vote.
Carpenter. Yes. Klein.
Yes.
Smalley.
Yes.
Savitsky.
Yes.
Lee.
Yes.
Let the record show that the motion carries unanimously. Next item is to purchase a blower for the sewer plant. As we discussed before, the blower has gone down at the sewer plant. New one will be approximately $10,500. And it'll be getting that installed. This is considered an emergency because if the other blower goes down, the plant will go down. So that has actually already been ordered because it was an emergency, but we have to have a vote on it tonight because it's such a large amount of money.
Make a motion we purchase the blower for the sewer plant at $10,500 cost.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any further discussion?
Talked to Mr. Patterson this evening. They ended up coming out and installing a soft start due to the blower motor was actually drawing too many amps and tripping it out, kicking it out. So this way with the soft start, it barely starts that motor running slowly, and that way it'll be able to be used also at a new plant if we need to. But instead of costing $10,500, it was between $3,000 to $5,000.
That's good news. Glad it was able to convert it to the FD. We didn't know if it could do that with our equipment or not.
Is there a warranty on this purchase?
Yes. I don't know the warranty yet, the length of it, but there is a warranty on it.
Okay. We can find out what it is. I'd like to have that put in the minutes to the meeting so in future reference we'll know how long it'll be.
Okay. We'll get that and put it on the agenda for the next meeting and have that information brought forward. Okay, any other discussion? Call for the vote.
Klein?
Yes.
Smalley?
Yes.
Savitsky?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Next item on the agenda is the Mid-Cumberland vouchers.
Make a motion to allow Westmoreland to have Mid-Cumberland vouchers.
Second.
Do I need to add system or just vouchers? So do I need to add system after that or just vouchers program?
Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve Mid-Cumberland vouchers for Westmoreland to be able to use the Mid-Cumberland services. for ones that were not here for the work study. That is to help folks pay water bills, utility bills, things like that. And the city did not have a program set up to that. So this is to start the paperwork to make that happen for citizens of Westmoreland. Anything you need to add?
Oddly enough, I'm the one that brought this to your attention. I've discussed with a couple of you. My concern with Mid-Cumberland is that it's in Gallatin, which makes it difficult for our residents to get there. The ones that probably need the help are going to have the hardest time getting there. I can work out something with the vouchers and the delay in the payment. That's not really the problem. My concern is getting down there. I'm fine with, you know, if y'all choose to pass okaying it to use the vouchers. In addition, I still feel like we need to look for
more options.
More options in addition to this. I don't think this is the solution that we need. I think it's maybe a good start, but I don't think this is the solution that we're looking for.
Is there a time period that we could put in place to try it, or?
It's okay. Like she had talked to us about earmarking the money that we send to them for Westmoreland. We may want to look at, are we going to do that, or are we going to say that the money that we've been sending to them, we want to send it somewhere local, make it more available to the people who aren't able to get to Gallatin. I just don't know what the answer is. The money that we've already sent this year was not earmarked for just Westmoreland. So that's not to say they won't help Westmoreland. They will, but it's just not already set aside for us.
Well, with these vouchers, even if it just helps one person, it's still one person wasn't getting the aid that they needed to keep the water on or lights on or whatnot.
Right. As it is right now, nobody that goes to Mid-Cumberland can be helped.
Here in the city?
Here, yes. But if you vote to approve it, then, you know, there may be at least a few people that can be helped.
You have the information, you can vote for it or vote against it. Any other discussion? We'll call for the vote.
Smalling?
Yes.
Savitsky?
Yes.
Leith?
Yes.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Klein?
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries unanimously. Next item on the agenda is a beer permit for Hollingsworth Oil, which is a Southern service.
Hello. I'm Rebecca Harris, and I'm representing Hollingsworth Oil Southern service. And they're saying they will be open by October, the second week in October. So between the first and second week, we should be in business.
Mr. Mayor, I have asked Tim to talk to us about the process of applying for a beer permit. And also, I had some discrepancies in the application that will need to be changed before we make the final approval.
Okay.
If you want to talk about how we approve these.
Well, basically, they just need to give an application, and they can go through PBI online and do their background check. I think some of them think they could do it locally. We've had that problem in the past, but the checks have to be certified background checks through TBI. They can't be done to the sheriff's office or any local agency. The only reason I'm really up here is to there's a discrepancy on locations on both beer permits. Just need to amend that in our approval of the beer permits to the right addresses and the right places.
On the Hollingsworth Oil beer application, item number 15, it's listed as Pleasant Grove Road is the nearest church, Crossroads Church, at 5254 is the neighboring church, and it's not listed on the application. So we'll have to make that change.
That can be put on the original.
Correct, John.
Is there any problem with the distance requirement?
No.
Okay, so that's just an
It's just a matter of record, that's all it is.
Yeah, that's what I'm approving with that amendment. That's my motion.
Second.
Both background checks came back clear, plus my additional checks that I do on both individuals applying tonight, they all came back clear.
So motion to accept with that one change, right?
And I'll second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to accept it with the change of the name church and I guess the address of it. Any other discussion?
I've got some. You probably don't know me, but you'll ask around here, you'll learn me. I'm glad for your business. I'm tickled with your business because I like Taco Bell. Yeah. So I'm going to do business with you.
Yes, we're actually going to have a chicken place in there too.
Well, I like that
with
too.
With our business.
That'd be fine. But my thing is, I don't support beer. I'm not nothing against you or your business. It's yes, the beer thing. I just don't support it, and so I don't vote for beer permits. Mm-hmm. So that's why. When you see my vote, you'll know why.
Okay.
It's not got a thing to do with you.
I understand.
Any other comments?
Appreciate you taking the time to come.
Yes.
As long as we have one. If we had three, we'd have a real problem. It'd be illegal.
I've actually enjoyed this, listening to this.
Ms. Kelly, when you're ready, I'll let you call.
Savitsky.
Yes.
Lee.
Yes.
Carpenter.
Yes.
Fine.
No.
Smaller.
Yes.
Let the record reflect that the motion carries 4-1. 4-4, 1 against. Appreciate you coming to Westmore.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Next item on the agenda is a beer permit for Michael Wayne Barber.
Can I say something before you? Well, you don't support the beer. We are going to serve coffee, tea, Cokes. We're going to have TVs, sports, okay. For sports. Come out, watch sports, and you know, have a nice, clean place.
You'll never know. You don't ever know about me. I've been known to do some.
We welcome anybody over 21. Right. We're going to get a smoke. You know, have a nice place smoking. We don't want nobody under 21, that's why we're going over 21. And we're not going to have no trouble with none of that.
We have the slight same issue that we had with Ms. Harris. Number 16, it states Westmoreland Middle School. It should be Westmoreland High School is the closest one.
Well, I didn't know if it was a high school or middle school.
It's all right. We just need to change the address to 4300 from 4126, I believe it is.
Yes.
And I'll make that motion.
Which one is it that it's supposed to be?
Number 16 should be 4300 Hawkins Drive, the Westmoreland High School.
I'll second it. And what item number?
16.
Like I said, it's just a matter of record, but I do check the distances just to make sure things are moving.
We only have a live band. You like playing food too?
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any further discussion?
Same thing. So I can have to run over this. You understand where I'm coming from, so I don't have to go no further.
We can what you come out.
Okay.
Okay, Ms. Kelly, whenever you're ready.
Lee?
Yes.
Carpenter?
Yes.
Klein?
No.
Smalling?
Yes.
Spitzky?
Yes.
Thank you.
Let the record reflect it's 4-4 the motion, 1 against the motion. It passes 4-1.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Barber.
mayor's mileage won't have to be voted on as part of the budget, so look for a motion to adjourn.
Make a motion.
Have a motion?
Second.
Second. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
We're adjourned.
Told you one thing.